first page. On. सर उस लिंक पे already on. Good afternoon, everyone. Today is your practical class, and the topic is antibiotic susceptibility testing. So, why we need antibiotic susceptibility testing? Suppose a patient came to the any OPD having pus discharge and something on any part of your body. Then that pus is collected in a container and it is sent to the laboratory. And that pus have grown some organism. Now that organism, depending upon whether it is GPC, whether it is GNB or anything else, so depending upon that, the clinician wants whether that organism is susceptible to which antibiotic. Na? So something is grown in the culture. So you as a microbiologist, you have to give the report of antibiotic susceptibility testing. So to it helps the clinician to prescribe an appropriate antibiotic so that the disease can be cured. Because in this era of antimicrobial resistance, if unnecessarily giving drugs to a antibiotics to a patient, it will automatically lead to antimicrobial resistance. So for any institute, there is an antibiotic policy which they follow depending upon their culture reports, depending upon their clinical data available, that in which patients which antibiotics helps. So every institute has its own antibiotic policy. So these policies are made by the various datas which we provide by antibiotic susceptibility testing. So in this practical class, you would not to know that what are the different types of antibiotic susceptibility testing methods, and then what are the various methods, how, what are you all need and how they are interpreted. Okay, so the classification of antibiotic susceptibility testing methods is broadly classified into diffusion methods, dilution methods, e-test, automated methods and molecular methods. So broadly you have to know that there are phenotypic methods and there are molecular methods. Okay, in phenotypic methods you have disc diffusion methods where disc is incorporated into a agar medium or any medium, and that disc of antibiotic get diffused and the organism which is grown around that disc is neutralized. So we will talk it about details in later slides. So basically these are disc diffusion methods, dilution methods, e-test method. E-test method is basically your diffusion plus dilution both, and it is an exponential growth method. Okay, the other one is your automated methods. Automated methods means minimum requirement of manual handling. Then molecular methods like PCR, polymerase chain reaction, which detects drug resistant genes we are using. So in disc diffusion methods, the most commonly method used is Kirby-Ward disc diffusion method. In the right side of the slide you are seeing a culture plate in which some round and circular discs are incorporated. So as you have already discussed in your previous lectures that what are the different types of culture medias and what are the culture medias you need for antimicrobial susceptibility testing. For in our institute, and most commonly method, most commonly media which we use for antimicrobial susceptibility testing is your Mueller-Hinton broth. Okay, Mueller-Hinton agar. Broth and agar, you know na difference. Okay, broth is a liquid media and agar is usually a solidifying agent. So for any broth, if you want to solidify it, we use we add agar. Okay, so we commonly use a Mueller-Hinton agar. So in this is the petri dish plate of around 90 mm, 9 cm. So we have two plates, petri dish plates. One is of 9 cm diameter and one of 15 cm diameter. Okay, so we will talk it from beginning. Any sample have sent to the bacteriology lab, it is then primary culture is done on blood agar, McConkie agar, or depending upon what the differential diagnosis of the patient. Then you got an isolated colonies on the culture media. From that, after overnight incubation, when you get an isolated colonies, you make a 0.5 McFarland inoculum from the culture which you have taken. Okay, so 0.5 McFarland, what is 0.5 McFarland? 0.5 McFarland, these are standards in which standards of dilution of the organism or the culture you have taken from that plate into a medium. Okay, so 0.5 McFarland is a standard inoculum that we use for drug antibiotic susceptibility testing. Okay, so after making this 0.5 McFarland unit, we do a lawn culture in our MHA plate. MHA is Mueller-Hinton agar plate. Now the surface of agar plate seeded with a lawn of test organism. Okay, after lawning, lawn culture ke baad, then we put discs of the size of the disc is almost 6 mm. So in a 9 centimeter diameter plate, we usually put 6 discs, and in 15 centimeter diameter plate, we usually put 12 discs. Okay, so these discs containing known concentration of agent, it has a definite concentration hoti hai in disc ki that we put into the agar plate. Then after putting it, we have to put these MHA plates into the overnight incubation, 37 degree centigrade. Okay, after that we see the plate next day, and in the right side of the picture you see these are discs around that a certain zone is present in which there is no growth of organism. So this is called the zone of inhibition. So the we actually measure it with a ruler scale, and the maximum diameter which is present from the center of the disc, so we usually give it as in this centimeter. Okay, so these the zone of inhibition which we usually get, we compare it with the known standard which have been provided to us, so that we can give whether it is susceptible or it is resistant or it is intermediate. Okay, so we usually in disc diffusion method we usually give it as either susceptible or resistant or intermediate. So the standards by which we take comparisons, usually there are two organizations like CLSI and UCAST. So these CLSI and UCAST give their reference values by which we can compare it, and we can see whether the process which we have done is right or wrong. Okay, so this is about the disc diffusion method. I think this is the same which I have already told. In lower down the slide, there is a standard strain of quality control. Quality control is for every batch. We usually put once in a week, we put strain of Staphylococcus aureus, Escherichia coli, one is GPC, one is GNB, and one is nil fermenter, that is the Pseudomonas aeruginosa. Okay, so these are the ATCC, this is the American type culture collection. So we have the strains, these strains we have preserved in our lab. So we usually put in usually in a week, so that we can check whether the disc which we are putting every day, they are giving right values or wrong values. Okay. Why we are using MHA, Müller-Hinton-Agar? Müller-Hinton-Agar is basically composed of your beef extract, casein, starch, and agar. Okay, so these are basically your source of carbon, nitrogen. This MHA have been studied from a long duration of time, that it gives consistently good results, and the batch to batch reproducibility is good in MHA. So we usually take this MHA as a standard for your antibiotic susceptibility testing. The other methods will be taken by Dr. Saurabh.
Good afternoon all. Now I am continuing the other methods. The other method, the first one is the same plate comparative disc diffusion test. It is also known as Stokes method. Here we use three zones: control zone, test zone, and the other one is also the control zone. And in the control zone, we use here the standard organisms which we will take from the ATCC, and the test zone we here use the test organisms, and here MHA plate divided into three parts. Test organism is inoculated on the central one third, and the control stand on the upper and lower one third. And here the other method is the modified Stokes method. Here the test organism is inoculated over upper and lower one third, and the control one on the central one third. This method is also the same as the disc diffusion method. Here we also compare the zone of inhibition. Zone of inhibition, the standard of zone of inhibition is taken from the CLSI. CLSI is the American guidelines which is the clinical and laboratory standard issued. And the other methods are the microbial dilution antibiotic susceptibility test. Here we use the broth. Here we use MHA broth and the microtiter plate. which having containing the 80 to 96 or other microvilles are in it. And the reference method used here is also the CLSI and UCAST. UCAST is European Committee on Antibiotic Susceptibility Testing. And here the method is the serial dilution of antimicrobial agents from the high concentration to low concentration is used in the liquid medium. Here the media used is the cation adjusted Müller-Gilton broth, and the standard bacterial suspension which is added in each well is 0.5 macfarlane. The concentration of bacteria for 0.5 macfarlane is 1.5 into 10 to the power 8 CFU per ml bacterium is added in each well. And this, after adding the organism, this microtiter plate is incubated for the 37 degree centigrade for overnight incubation, that is 18 to 24 hours. And then the wells are visualized for the turbidity by using the viewing mirror. And here the lowest concentration which inhibits the visible growth of microorganisms is known as the MIC. MIC means minimum inhibitory concentration. And the other method which used is agar dilution method. Agar dilution method means to determine the MIC. This is also the minimum inhibitory concentration of the antimicrobial agents. Here, serial dilutions of the drugs are prepared in molten agar. This is the molten agar. This is Müller-Gilton agar here, but in the molten, in melted form. And it is taken in the petri dish, and the test strain is inoculated in this. And several strains can be tested at same time using same plate. After incubation, here minimum inhibitory concentration is determined by its lowest antimicrobial concentration. This can also measure the minimum bacterial cycle concentration also. And the other one test is the E test, which is also known as the epsilometer test. Epsilometer test is actually both here dilution and diffusion, both method will take place. And here a test strip is, here there is a test strip at which at various level there is the different drug concentration is kept. And after doing the long culture of the bacteria, the test strip is placed in the center of the culture, in center of the long culture. And it is placed overnight after 18 to 24 hours. Here we saw that there is the zone of inhibition, and the minimum concentration up to which the zone of inhibition is appeared is known as its MIC value. From upper, you will see here from the upper side the zone of inhibition will narrow down in the lower side. That means here in this picture we saw that at lowest 125 microgram, here the zone of inhibition will end. So this is the minimum concentration for this test organisms. Now this is the antibiotic gradient diffusion method. This is also the same as the dish diffusion. This is also same as the epsilon test. Here the same method is shown, which I told you previously. And now coming on the automated and semi-automated methods for the antibiotic susceptibility testing. Automated system means the device with computer-assisted incubation, reading, interpretation, and reporting function. There is no any manual work. No hands are used here. In semi-automated system, they require offline incubation. The panels are automatically read with computer, and reporting manual routing of each panel into the system is required. Here there is many automated and semi-automated methods like SensiTiger, MicroScan, Phoenix and Vitek 2. And here at the right corner we will see the reporting time, 18 to 24 hour and the other one. Now coming on the semi-automated method, which is known as the Vitek AST card. This is the method which generally used for the emergency purpose. Actually, this is the rapid method, accurate susceptibility testing and resistance detection, and it is self-contained disposable test card. This is rapid resistance detection and gives us the accurate diagnostic, and by this result we can start the effective therapy. And there is pre-applied barcode, and the lot of sample will be traceable at the minimum time, and this is the closed system having safe, disposable, ready to use cards. And the main thing is it decreased biohazardous waste. There is no any danger for spreading the bacteria or something in the environment. So and the principle on which the Vitek is work is, it is a uses a turbidimetric metric method, and for the susceptibility testing using a 64 well card containing serial dilution of antimicrobial agents. Here there is the horizontal line, there is horizontal and vertical one. The vertical one shows the serial dilution of the antimicrobial agents, and in this we just suspend the 0.5 microfarad of the turbidity of the organisms, and we just get the minimum inhibitory concentration of the antibiotic. This is the end of the class. Thank you everyone.
Thank you. Okay, so in the end of the lecture, you have learned about the what are the various types of antibiotic susceptibility testing methods. Basically, you should know that there are diffusion methods, these are dilution method, there are some diffusion plus dilution method, there are some automated methods, and your molecular methods like PCR. In your diffusion methods, you have to remember only two names: Kirby-Bohr disk diffusion method, and other one is your Stokes method. Okay. In Kirby-Bohr disk diffusion method, in the same plate only one organism can be tested, and you can use number 6 to 12 number of antibiotics. So a number of antibiotics you can use for only one organism. In Stokes, you can test two different organisms, but the number of antibiotics you can use is limited. So in Stokes, the same plate you have to use your control. The control is tested and the organism is tested. Okay. So, but for a different antibiotics, you have to use various number of plates. So Kirby-Bohr disk diffusion methods is preferred over your Stokes disk diffusion method. Okay, then your dilution method. In micro broad dilution methods, you know that your MICs, you will have to measure your MICs. These are your only dilution methods. You have to take broth, okay, you have to make serial dilutions of the your culture, and then you have to add the different concentration of antibiotic to it, and when there is a no visible growth seen after an overnight incubation, then that is the your MIC. Okay, so this is your dilution method. Then your e-test is your exponential gradient method, in which there is a diffusion plus dilution both. Okay, then at automated method, you have to just remember some names, and then molecular methods, PCR. So you don't have to just mug up all these things, you have to just remember the basic points which I have told in the end of this lecture. So, okay, that's all for today's practical class. Thank you.